So the row equivalent matrices means the row spaces of A and B are equal. Row space A equal to row space B. So we can write it as row A and row B as well, like it's the same. So row space of A equal to row space of B, then it's called row equivalent matrices. If we have two row equivalent matrices, then we have two, like we have like a theorem which says two statements, two things are true. The one is the given column vectors of A is linearly independent if and only, like the column vectors of A are linearly independent. Linearly independent if and only if column vectors of B are linearly independent. And the second one is the column vectors of the set of column vectors of A forms basis for column space. If and only if the corresponding set of column vectors of B forms basis for column space, the same column space. So if we have linearly independent column vectors and A, which means we have the linearly independent column vectors for B, and if we have a set of column vectors, like the set of like say 5 column vectors are there and 3 out of them are basis, forms the basis for the column space, and the corresponding 3 forms the basis for column space of the matrix B. So we'll go through with a question. So this is the theorem. The application of the theorem comes like this. So if we are given with a matrix A, which is 1, minus 3, 4, minus 2, 5, 4, and 2, minus 6, 9, minus 1, 8, 2, and 2, minus 6, 9, minus 1, 9, 7, and minus 1, 3, minus 4, 2, minus 5, minus 4. So we are given with this matrix, and we need to find, we are asked to find the column space, like the basis for the column space of this matrix. The vector should be like in this format, like vector should be one of, like vector should be a set of column vectors for this matrix. So we need to find a basis for the column space, and the vector should be one of, like a set of, a subset of these column vectors available for this matrix. So what can we do this, like when we apply the theorem? So we can transform this into row echelon form. So transforming to a row echelon form comprises of elementary row operations. Elementary row operation doesn't change the row space of this matrix. So if the row space doesn't change, if we have like say A dash with the row echelon form of this matrix, actually it is given in the lecture note. It's 1, minus 3, 4, minus 2, 5, 4, and 0, 0, 1, 3, minus 2, minus 6, and 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 5, and 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. So this is the row echelon form of this matrix. So we have two A and A dash, let's say this B. So we have two matrices, and the row echelon form of this matrix is given. So if so, we know that the basis for the column space of this matrix is this 1, 0, 0, and this 1 0 0 and 5 minus 2 0. So these three will form, since because we have one in the leading rows. So since these three column vectors form the basis for this column space, according to our theorem, which says that if these two are row equivalent, since we have done only the row operations, elementary row operation, the row space doesn't change. So which means we have we can apply that theorem, which says the basis for the column space of this matrix is equivalent to the corresponding basis for the corresponding matrix. So which means the basis for the column space of this matrix is this. So directly we can say that from the theorem, these three will form the basis for the column space of this matrices. And yeah, that's one of the application of the theorem. Stop.